Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 1. This is Section 2.2, Problem 1. It says the data shows the number of classes that 30 different BCC students are registered for this semester. So the data value of 3 represents a student that's registered for 3 classes this semester. So part A says, create a frequency distribution for this data. So the number of possible answers we have, nobody said 0 classes, so it does start with 1. There's 2, 3, 4, 5. One student even took 6 classes in a semester, and that's as high as it goes. So that'll be the first column of our frequency distribution. And we can label the columns too, classes taken. And then the second column will be frequency. So now what we want to do is count how many students out of the 30 signed up for one class in the semester. So count carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There were 6 different students that were registered for only one class during the semester. They're probably going part-time or whatever. So next is 2. How many students took 2 classes in a semester? So again, count them up carefully. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there were also 6 students that signed up for 2 classes. So the next data value is 3. How many students took 3 classes at a time? Or 3 classes in one semester? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There were 5 students that registered for 3 classes. How many students registered for 4 classes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There were 9 students registered for 4 classes at a time. How many students registered for 5 classes in one semester? It's 1, 2, 3. There were 3 students that registered for 5 classes in a single semester, and there was only 1 student, I see that's the only thing not crossed out. There was 1 student that registered for 6 classes. So this would be the frequency distribution. These are how many occurrences of each of the things in the first column. That's part A. So part B says create a relative frequency distribution for this data. So for a relative frequency distribution, it's going to be the same chart, essentially with one extra column on the end, where you're going to make a ratio of the frequency for that class over the total of all the frequencies. And again, we added all the frequencies. I know it should total up to 30. So let me set up the next chart. It's going to look very similar with one extra column. So the first column will still be classes taken. And I can just copy it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Same numbers. Frequency will be the same. So it's going to be 6 students that took 1 class, 6 students that took 2 classes, 5 students that took 3 classes, 9 students that took 4 classes, 3 students that took 5 classes, and only 1 student that took 6 classes in one semester. So now here's what's different. the relative frequencies. That's what makes this a relative frequency distribution as opposed to just a frequency distribution. Relative frequencies are the frequency for each class over the total of all the frequencies. And again, the total of all the frequencies would be 30. We added that up. So for the first class, the relative frequency for students taking only one class per semester would be the frequency for that class, 6, over the total of all the frequencies, which is 30. And then the same process right down. The relative frequency for students taking two classes at a time would be the frequency for the students taking two over the total of all the frequencies, again, 6 over 30. Relative frequency for students taking three classes at a time would be the frequency for students taking three classes, which is 5, over the total of all the frequencies, which would be 30. For four classes at a time, it would be the frequency of 9 over the total of all the frequencies, which is 30. And then for five classes at a time, three students did that, so a frequency of 3 over the total of all the frequencies, which is 30. And finally, the last category, six classes in one semester, frequency of only 1, total of all the frequencies is still 30. Now, notice some of these can reduce. You can certainly reduce them if you want to. You don't have to. You could turn in any of them into decimals. So for example, 6 over 30, with your calculator, you go 6 divided by 30 equals, and the calculator would tell you it's 0.2, so you could put that in if you want instead of the fractions. But the fractions are okay, those are the relative frequencies. Now, C, draw a histogram for the frequency distribution from part A. So if a histogram is, again, a special type of bar graph. The bars can only be drawn vertically for a histogram, and they have to touch. So if it just says bar graph, you can go horizontal or vertical, and they're not supposed to touch. This is a little special, the histogram. Vertical only, no horizontal, and they have to touch. So the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are going to be the labels for the bars. And then the 6, 6, 5, 9, 3, 1, the frequencies will be the heights of the bars. The highest bar that I'll have to deal with is 9. So in terms of my number scale, 1 at a time is a good number scale, up to at least 9. 10 would be okay. So let me just see if I can fit it right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's enough, but since I have room and it doesn't cost me anything, let's make it 10. I'll label it. Again, is unnecessary, but so the first bar for students taking only one class has a frequency of 6, so the height of the bar will be 6. I have 6 on my number scale. Again, note that the bar is vertical, and under the center of the bar, I put a 1 as the label for students to take only one class at a time. Next bar for students to take two classes at a time, also 6, frequency is 6, so the height will be 6, so the next bar is the same height. Also vertical, notice that it touches. Again, the label for that next bar is 2, which is representing students that register for two classes in one semester. The next bar, students that take three classes at a time, has a frequency of 5, so we'll have a height of 5. So it's going to be a little bit lower. Again, it's going to touch the other bars. It's labeled with a 3. The next bar will go up to the highest point, which is 9 for students who register for 4 classes. So here's my height of 9. Again, my bars will touch. I will continue the previous edge of the bar to 9. Bring it down. That's for 4. You have to label the bar. And the next bar, students who register for 5 classes at a time, goes up to a height of 3. It has a frequency of 3. Again, it's going to be vertical. It's going to touch the bar next to it. It gets labeled with a 5. And then one more bar for students to take 6 classes in one semester. It has a height only of 1, because only one student did that. It gets a 6. So I've labeled the bottoms of the bars. It's nice to label your histogram too. So we can label it number of classes taken per student in one semester, or something to that effect. So it has a label.